My name is Sam Wadsworth. I'm a postdoctoral research fellow at the James Hogg Research Centre at UBC in Vancouver, Canada. And the major goal of my research is to identify the molecular and cellular origins of lung diseases such as asthma and COPD. Well, our lab is really focused on epithelial biology. So we use varied culture techniques. We do grow other cell types, so we grow fibroblasts and smooth muscle cells. But as far as the epithelial cells are concerned, we use standard submerged culture techniques to proliferate the cells. But we also use air-liquid interface cultures to grow differentiated primary airway epithelial cells. So many of our epithelial surfaces are exposed to air. So our skin, the corneum of our eyes, and our airways are all exposed to air in vivo. And so air liquid interface culture is really just a way to recapitulate this physiological environment in the lab. So what we use is a semi-permeable membrane, and we seed cells onto that membrane. Now, what that allows us to do is to expose the upper surface of those epithelial cells to air, whilst growth factors and hormones can diffuse through from a liquid media below to those cells to keep them alive. Hence, we have an air-liquid interface. There are many different types of epithelial cells which are exposed to air. So we can use ALI cultures to grow skin cells, corneal cells, even intestinal cells. We're interested in airway epithelial cells. So ALI culture allows us to grow airway epithelium in a much more physiologically relevant environment. And what that does is it triggers the differentiation of those airway cells into a specialized mucociliated tissue. So airway epithelial cells grown as an ALI differentiate into mucus-producing and ciliated cells. Now, what that allows us to do is not just have a more accurate model of the airway epithelium in vitro, but it also allows us to use much more physiologically relevant experiments in our research. So we can apply things like cigarette smoke, nebulized drugs, particulate matter, all in an airborne manner onto the apical surfaces of those ALI cultures. We use pneumocal ALI for several reasons. One is that primary bronchial epithelial cells are expensive and difficult to obtain, and they only grow for a very limited lifespan. So we need a culture media that really gives us a consistent and reliable performance in air liquid interface culture. These ALI cultures take several weeks to develop, and so we need a media that really gives us, like I said, a reliable performance. We also need a media that gives us a consistently improved morphology and function of differentiated airway epithelial cultures. And we feel that this is what pneumocal ALI can offer.